What's up, everybody? Drew here. I got a copy. I got my hands on a copy of the lawsuit against the Texas Supreme Court. It's to be filed in the federal district court in the Northern District of Texas. The plaintiffs and then an association, or they're I guess representing the Association of Texas Non-Custodial Parents, right? And this is involving the Supreme Court order that says that you got to take kids back according to the school schedule. Now, here's the issues that they're coming up with. They're saying that it's an unconstitutional modification of Texas Family Code Section 153.132, which is a law concerning, I guess, the custody for spring break. They haven't mentioned twice here. There's also a violation of Article 3, Section of Texas Constitution, Article 3, Sections 29, 30, and 31. Those pertain to the powers of the legislature. A violation of public policy of Texas, the public policy of Texas. The memo. They're calling it a memo, contradicts a previous ruling made by the very same court. So this actual order contradicts what they've done before. And it's a violation of the 14th Amendment due process rights from interference with parent-child relationships. Okay, so this is where they're going to send it. This is the respondents and stuff like that. I think there's a formality when you have federal documents. It says on March 17th, 2020, the Supreme Court issued an order they're referring to as a memo that had the effect of enacting and revising Texas law regarding parent-child relationships and modifying all court orders in existence that have an effect on parent-child relationships. The memo violates the Texas Constitution and 14th Amendment due process rights. It was done because of the coronavirus pandemic, and specifically said for the purposes, the Supreme Court issued an order, basically said you had to take the kids back according to the school calendar, right? Now, their first issue is an unconstitutional modification of the Texas Family Code. The Texas Family Code is right here. If you look at it, Texas Family Code, Section 153.312, for parents who reside 100 miles or less apart. The school's spring vacation and ending at 6 p.m. on the day before school resumes after that vacation. That's what it says in the law. Okay, that's what it says in the law. It doesn't say according to the school calendar. There's no mention of school calendar anywhere in here. Okay, it's important to remember what is and what is not inside the law. All right, the memo has the effect of modifying, revising the Texas Family Code, which it does. It says you got to take them back to the school calendar. But the law doesn't say that. Texas law requires that custody orders contain the language of the law, and the memo has the effect of modifying the custody orders without due process of law. A possessory conservator is a person who does not get primary custody of the child. They can be considered the parent who loses the custody battle. According to the Texas Office of the Attorney General, 90% of possessory conservators are not mothers, right? And there's a website right there in case you want to look it up. The Texas Family Code, Section 153.132, which is up here, clearly states that the child shall be returned at 6 p.m. the day before school resumes after spring vacation. All right. Supreme Court of Texas cannot simply rewrite the law. The memo, so real quick, what they did was basically they rewrote the law. This is the law. It doesn't say anything about the calendar in here. So they rewrote the law, pretty much. The memo violates Article 1, Section 28 of the Texas Constitution, Article 1, 28, suspension of laws. All right. So going to Texas Constitution, Article 1, Section 28, no power of suspending the laws in this state shall be exercised except by the legislature. So, if anything, what they're doing is maybe suspending a law, and only the legislature can do that. The memo relied upon Texas government code to support the revision of law of a custody order. In this case, no conduct of court proceedings in reference to this order. It is simply stating that possession access shall not be affected by the school's closure. All right, that's from the Supreme Court order, their memo. Only the Texas legislature can suspend the laws. Okay, so the Texas legislature has held no session to address the corona break issue, nor have they revised Texas Family Code 3112, which is the spring break. Did the Supreme Court of Texas assume the powers of the Texas legislature when they issued this memo? Yes, they did. Of course they did. Only the legislature has that power. The Supreme Court memo violates Article 3, Sections 29, 30, and 31 of the Texas Constitution. The enacting clause of laws. The enacting clause of all laws shall be it enacted by the legislature of Texas. So only the legislature can enact laws. Laws have to be passed by bill. Amendments changing its purpose are prohibited. No law shall be passed except by bill. And no bill shall be so amended in its passage through either house as to change its original purpose. So you can't have a law unless it's been started off as a bill, right? And basically the second part doesn't really apply. This is just like, you know, during the process of enacting law. But only the legislature has the power to pass laws. And here it is right here. The origination in either house. Bills may originate in either house. And when passed by such house may be amended, altered, or rejected by the other. So if the House of Representatives tries to get a bill passed, the Senate can reject it, and vice versa. If the Senate wants to get a bill passed, the House can reject it, right? But bills may originate in either House, okay? It doesn't say in the Supreme Court, in the judicial branch, okay? So all this right here is under the powers of the legislature. It's not a power of the judicial branch. Only the Texas legislature can enact laws, and those laws must start as a bill and be accepted through the regular course of business for the enactment of a law. The memo issued by the Supreme Court of Texas has the same effect as a new law or a revision of the law, and thus violates the separation of powers. All right. This memo violates the public policy of Texas. Now, in the Texas Family Code, all right, the policy and general application guidelines established a minimum policy for joint managing conservator, right, which is the says right here, joint managing conservator is a fancy name for a parent who is not the custodial parent. This minimum guideline is referred to as a standard possession order, which is described in section 153.312. The standard possession, which is the where we find the spring break law. Okay, the standard possession order essentially restricts a joint managing conservator possession of the child to 95 to 110 days per year. These parents are only lawfully allowed to possess their children 26% of a given year. All right, the public policy of Texas regarding children and their parents. All right, which is this law right here. It's the first law in section 153. Public policy. The public policy of the state is to assure that children will have frequent and continuing contact with the parents who have shown the ability to act in the best interest of the child, provide a safe and stable nonviolent environment, and encourage parents to share in the rights and duties of raising their child after the parents have separated or dissolved their marriage. Right. This is the public policy of Texas. That's what the judges and everybody is supposed to base all their decisions off of, but they don't. Right. So given that, given that the public policy wants parents to have a lot of time with their kids, would the public policy support any additional time a joint managing conservator receives in compliance with the public policy of Texas? Okay. So given that parents usually get 26% a year and now it's spring break and they get more time, it would be public policy to give them more time with their kids. Okay. So a government action, which is a violation of the authority and rights defined and granted in the government's constitution, is unconstitutional. Most constitutions set forth the powers of government so that the constitution normally applies only to government actions. An action of state or federal governments through any of its agencies and bodies is subject to constitutional limits. So the Supreme Court is subject to constitutional limits. Like, they can't go and revise laws and make them up and misinterpret them. Now, here's a good one right here. This is probably the best one here. The memo contradicts a previous ruling made by the very same court. Okay. The law is to be interpreted as written. The following is an excerpt from a Supreme Court ruling on how they interpret the law. Iliff versus Iliff, right, came out of the Supreme Court in 2011. Now, you got to look at this. Statutory construction. In construing a statute, right, in understanding and reading a statute, the court's purpose is to give effect to the legislature's expressed intent. Nowhere in this law concerning the spring break, okay, does it say anything about calendars. Okay, it doesn't. Doesn't say anything about calendars, all right? So there's no expressed intent in the calendars. Now, the Supreme Court goes on to say, our role is not to second-guess the policy choices that inform our statutes or to weigh the effectiveness of their results. Rather, our task is to interpret those statutes in a manner that effectuates the legislature's intent. Now, if it's public policy to ensure that children spend time with their parents, wouldn't the intent of the legislature be that on spring break, if it's extended, those children get to stay with those parents for a little bit longer, being that those parents only get 26% of the year? That would be the legislature's intent, right? I mean, they're not bad guys. They didn't want to keep people from their kids. It even says in public policy to ensure that they have frequent continuing contact with their parents. All right. Now, in McIntyre versus Ramirez, this was a case in 2003, which was before 2011. Okay. This came out of there. Where statutory language is unambiguous and only yields one reasonable interpretation, we will interpret the statute according to its plain meaning. This is another case, City of Rockwall versus Hughes in 2008. Okay. That language up here, it doesn't say it's not ambiguous. Sorry, it's right here. It's not ambiguous. It says the day before school resumes after that vacation. Spring break is still going on in some places, okay? So the statute, according to its plain meaning, it's not ambiguous. It says return the kid after the day before school resumes. It doesn't say according to the calendar. It says to the school calendar. It says the day before school resumes, all right? That is what the Supreme Court said themselves, okay? The Texas Supreme Court. We construe the statute's words according to their plain and common meaning unless a contrary intention is apparent from the context or unless such a construction leads to absurd results, okay? So letting parents spend more time with their kids during spring break, and it just so happens that coronavirus extended spring break, this is not absurd, especially when you look at it from the public policy standpoint right here. Okay, we want children to spend time with their parents. So it's not absurd. Okay, school's going to return. Those kids are going to go back with their parents, with the custodial parent. And then they're going to have their makeup time in the summer, so that summer visitation is going to get interfered with. This spring break is for the non-custodial parents this year. Okay, Nothing in the law allows the Supreme Court to say that it goes by the calendar year. That's not what the legislature said. They're making that shit up, and they're legislating from the bench, okay? Now, Texas law is clear that children are to be returned the day before school resumes after spring break. That's what it says. All right, now here's some other stuff that says that the memo violates 14th Amendment due process rights, right? Children and parents possess a constitutionally protected liberty interest in companionship and society with each other. Ninth Circuit, that's a federal court, held that the state's interference with such liberty interests without due process of law is grounds for a 1983 lawsuit, okay? Parents' right implicates both a custodial and companionship interest, either in which they interfered with by the state gives rise to a grounds for a 14th Amendment due process claim. Okay, so you can sue when the state interferes with your rights. All right, recognizing parents. Well, this right here was just something specific to that case. And the code of judicial canons in Texas. Those are like rules for the judges. They say judges shall accord to every person who has a legal interest in a proceeding or that person's lawyer the right to be heard according to law. Right. So at no point was a public notice given regarding this decision made by the Supreme Court of Texas. The citizens of Texas were given no opportunity to be heard regarding their thoughts and opinions. The parents affected by the situation have been given no opportunity to be heard by a judge. Instead, a secret closed-door meeting was held that effectively rewrote the custody orders, as per the 14th Amendment of the United States Constitution. Okay, all persons born or naturalized in the United States and subject to the jurisdiction thereof are citizens of the United States, and no state shall make or enforce any law which shall abridge the privileges or immunities of the citizens, nor shall any state deprive any person of life, liberty, or property without due process of law, nor deny any person within its jurisdiction the equal protection of laws. So it's due process right to be able to go to a hearing and be served with paperwork and all this other stuff before they modify your court orders, okay? So they're asking for a declaratory relief that the Supreme Court memo is unconstitutional, all right? So basically, the Supreme Court modified everybody's order, and it goes against the public policy of Texas, right? It goes against public policy, and it goes against what they even said themselves, that they will look at the law and read it as is. They're not there to make shit up. That's not their job. Their job is not to make stuff up. It's to interpret the law, and the law says right here, okay, the child is to be returned for spring after school spring vacation and ends, they're supposed to be returned at 6 p.m. on the day before school resumes after that vacation. Okay, that's what it says. They cannot change the law. None of these judges issuing standing orders, none of that stuff is valid. It's all void. Don't listen to it. It's void. Don't listen to it. Okay, even the Supreme Court, they got it wrong. Okay, they got it wrong. They even went against their own freaking words. All right, you guys, have a good one. Talk to you soon.